Special meeting at Columbia Road Baptist Church. We're glad that you've joined us, whether here in person tonight or whether by means of technology from your homes. We're praying that tonight would be a blessing to you as we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ in song and in scripture. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among all women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God.
Help me.
If you're able to, let's stand to our feet and we'll sing the Christmas carol together, It Came Upon the Midnight Clear.
It came upon a midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from heaven's all-gracious King.
Seated, we'll sing, O come, Emmanuel, God with us.
Until the
Luke chapter 2. The word of God reads in chapter 1 and verse 26. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto the city of Galilee, named Nazareth. And let's skip forward to Luke chapter 2. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds, abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. We find the very crux of human history, all of history up to this point looking towards this moment, and all of us in this day and age looking back to the birth of the Savior, the light of the world.
Thank you.
Let's stand together as we sing Joy to the World, as we lift our voices as well in the praise of the birth of our Savior.
Joy to the world.
Child is born on earth.
Today a child. is love. He is grace born on Christmas Day. He is light. He is love. He is grace born on Christmas Day. He is light. He is love. He is grace born on Christmas Day.
At this time, the ushers are going to be making their way around in order to help light the candles. Just as a note, keep your candle upright if it's lit, and bring to the, from the side the unlit candle to it so that nobody gets hot wax poured on them. And our young friends, this is the time to turn on your electric lights that you've been given. Once again, if you're able, would you stand with me as we sing Silent Night?
Savior is born. Silent night, holy night, Son of God, love's pure light, radiant peace from thy holy face, with the dawn of redeeming grace, Jesus, Lord, at thy birth, Jesus, Lord, at thy birth. Silent night, holy night, wondrous star, lend thy light, with the angels let us sing.
Thank you. You may be seated. The Word of God reads in Galatians chapter 4, in verse number 4, "But when the fullness of time was come, God sent forth his Son, made of a woman, made under the law, to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons." That iconic picture of Christmas time and a baby in a manger go hand in hand, don't they? The idea of Jesus coming to the manger is a beautiful, peaceful happening, as we've sang about. But we don't leave him in a manger. We follow his life through his sinless life on earth, and finally, until we see him stepping to the place of the cross, taking your sin and my sin upon him, all of the wrong things we've thought or said or done were placed upon the Lord Jesus, and he willingly bore in his own body on the tree the sins of mankind. And when he died for us and as us. But when he died, he did not stay dead, but he rose from the grave on the third day. And that, my friends, is why we celebrate Christmas. Not just that a baby or a religious leader or a man who spoke comforting things came into the world, but that the Savior of the world, God in the flesh, lived among us. Not just by happenstance, but on purpose, that he might redeem us, to buy us back out of the dangers of sin, which he so mercifully did for us. The Bible says about this great gift that God gave at Christmas time, it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Do you have that everlasting life that the Word of God talks about? Was there a time when you trusted the Lord Jesus as your Savior? I'm not asking if you're a good person or a bad person. I'm not asking if you belong to a church. I'm not asking if you pay your taxes and help the elderly cross the street. What I'm asking, if there was ever a moment when you, realizing that you were a sinner, called on Christ for salvation. I was an 18-year-old young man when I knelt down by the side of my bed and I prayed and I asked the Lord to forgive my sins and be my Savior. The Word of God reads in verse 13 of Romans chapter 10, "For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." That's you. That's me. That open invitation is why we celebrate the forgiveness of sins, eternal life, adoption into God's family. These are the things that the Lord Jesus brings to those who place their faith and trust in him. Amen. Children? Hark the herald angels sing. Let's stand together and sing this Christmas carol. Thank you, young people. You did such a wonderful job. You looked so nice. Thank you for blessing us in song tonight. As we stand and sing, hark the herald angels sing. And I want to thank you for being with us this evening as we have celebrated the birth of the Lord Jesus. And this is a season of gift giving, and perhaps you have picked out the perfect gift for somebody in your life, and you just cannot wait for them to open it here in a few days. I want you to know that the best gift that was ever given, as we've read about tonight, was the Lord Jesus Christ. And the best thing that you could ever give somebody this Christmas is hope. This is a year when we've all needed hope. I don't know that a year goes by where we don't need it, but this year especially. And that hope is found in the Lord. And so I'd like to challenge you to do two things as you head on your way into other Christmas festivities this week. The first thing is, if you've never received that gift of eternal life, you've never prayed and asked the Lord to be your Savior, I'd like you, if you would, if you were invited here by somebody, or perhaps someone shared this with you online, or you want to reach out to us directly, perhaps after the service tonight or sometime in the future, we want to speak with you about the Lord. You can pray and receive the Lord right now, right where you are. But if you have questions, if you have needs, we want to be here to help you through that. The second thing is, you can give the gift of hope to someone. Tell them about the Lord Jesus this Christmas season. Let them know that he understands the struggles that they are going through, and that he will be with them always. Those that trust him as Savior have the promise of a Savior who never leaves, a friend that's closer than a brother. Let's bring that gift of hope to those we're going to share this Christmas season with. In just a moment, we're going to sing "We Wish You a Merry Christmas," and then we'll be dismissed to head out on our ways. I'd like to encourage you that before you get up and head out, that you would extinguish your flame so that we don't have any unfortunate incidents. If you would do that, I'd appreciate it. Yes, the young ones who have the electronic ones, you can keep that. We thought about collecting them back and sanitizing them, and we thought, nah. There'll be more fun in the hands of our young friends. Let's stand once more before we conclude tonight, and we'll sing the song together, "We Wish You a Merry Christmas."
We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
May the Lord bless you. And Merry Christmas. Say an encouraging word on your way out tonight.